In this video, I am going to explain about quartile deviation. The positional measure of dispersion based on the quartiles is used. It is called quartile deviation. So, formula for quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So, this Q1 is called lower quartile and this Q3 is called upper quartile. Next, coefficient of quartile deviation. The relative measure of dispersion based on the quartiles is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Formula for coefficient of quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Now, we are going to find the value of quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. For that, the problems are given either in the form of individual series or discrete series or in the form of continuous series. Suppose if the data are given in the form of individual series, we have to use the formula, that is Q1 equal to size of n plus 1 by 4th term. Q1 is lower quartile and formula is n plus 1 by 4th term. This n is nothing but the number of terms. Next, Q3 equal to size of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th term. This Q3 is nothing but upper quartile. Next, formula for discrete series, Q1 equal to size of capital N plus 1 by 4th term. This N is nothing but total frequency. In the case of individual series, N is total number of observation. And in the case of discrete series, N, that is capital N, is total frequency. Next, formula for Q3, size of 3 into N plus 1 by 4th term. Next, continuous series. Formula for Q1 is L plus N by 4 minus cumulative frequency divided by frequency into C. And formula for Q3 is L plus 3N by 4 minus CF divided by F into C. See, the only difference is here N by 4 and here we have 3N by 4. So, these are all the formulas for individual series, discrete series and in the case of continuous series. Now we will solve an example. In this example, we have to find quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. And here we have a series of data. So this is the form of individual series. So first we have to arrange the data in the ascending order. So what is the first term? That is minimum value is 3. Next greater value is 4. Next highest value 6. Next one is 8, 9, 12 and 16. So first we have to arrange the data in the form of ascending order. Now we have to find Q1 and Q3. So formula for Q1 in the case of individual series is size of N plus 1 by 4th term. So that is size of, what is N? How many number of terms we have? Here we have 7 terms. So 7 plus 1 by 4th term. So 7 plus 1, that is nothing but 8. So size of 8 by 4th term, that is size of second term. 8 by 4, that is nothing but second. So second term. So in the ascending order form, what is the second term? So that is 4. So value of Q1 is 4. Okay, next we have to find Q3 term. Q3, formula for Q3 in the case of individual series is size of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th term. So that is nothing but 3 into n is nothing but 7. So we have 7 terms. So 7 plus 1 by 4th term. So 3 into 7 plus 1 by 4, that is 8 by 4. 8 by 4 is 2. So 3 into 2, that is nothing but 6th term. So in the ascending order, 6th term is, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is 12. So 12 is the 6th term. So therefore Q3 value is 12. So after finding Q1 and Q3, we have to find quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. So first we'll find out quartile deviation. So formula for quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So substitute the values. Q3 is 12 minus Q1 value is 4. So 4 divided by 2. So 12 minus 4, 8 by 2, that is 4. So quartile deviation value is 4. Next, coefficient of quartile deviation. So formula for coefficient of quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. So that is 12 minus 4 divided by, because Q3 is 12, Q1 is 4. 12 plus 4. So 12 minus 4, that is 8 divided by 12 plus 4, that is 16. So if you divide, you will get 1 by 2, that is nothing but 0.5. So therefore, coefficient of quartile deviation value is 0.5. Next, we will solve an example in the case of discrete series. Here we have an example. And marks, number of students are given. Marks, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60. And number of students, that is nothing but frequency. 4, 7, 15, 8, 7 and 2, the values are given. So first we have to find cumulative frequency. So first we have to write the frequency value, that is 4, first value. Next we have to add with the second value, so 4 plus 7, that is 11, so 11 plus next value, that is 15, so you will get 26. Next 26 plus 8, that is 34, next 34 plus 7, that is 41, next 41 plus last value 2, so that is 43. So next n total, that is nothing but sigma f, so that is 43. Now we have to find quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. So before that, first we'll find out the values of q1 and q3. So q1 equal to size of capital N plus 1 by 4th term. This n is nothing but total frequency. So size of n, what is n? That is 43 plus 1 by 4th term. So 43 plus 1, 44 divided by 4, that is nothing but 11th term. So now we have to check whether 11 is in the cumulative frequency or not. So here we have 11, so that corresponds to marks, that is 20, that is x value, that is 20. So value of q1 is 20. Next we have to find q3. So formula for q3 is size of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th term. So that is nothing but 3 into n plus 1 by 4, that is 43 plus 1 by 4, 44 divided by 4th term. So that is 3 into 11th term, so that is 33rd term. Okay, so now you have to check whether 33 is in the cumulative frequency value. See, here we don't have 33, but 33 is lies in between these two values, that is 26 and 34. So 33 lies in between these two values. We have to consider the highest value, that is 34. This corresponds to x value is 40. So q3 value is 40. So we have Q1 is 20 and Q3 is 40. So now we have to find out quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. So first, quartile deviation formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So Q3 is 40 minus Q1 is 20 divided by 2. That is 20 by 2. So that is 10. So the value of quartile deviation is 10. Next, coefficient of quartile deviation formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. So substitute the values, 40 minus 20 divided by 40 plus 20. So that is 20 divided by 60. So if you divide, you will get 0.333. So this is the value of coefficient of quartile deviation. Next example, in the case of continuous series, here we have to find value of quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation, and we have class limits and frequency values are given. Class limits, that is from 0 to 10 till 60 to 70, values are given, and corresponding frequency 8, 20, 34, 46, 28, 14 and 10 values are given. So now we have to find Q1 and Q3. So for that we have to find the cumulative frequency value. So for finding cumulative frequency, first consider the frequency value, that is 8. So first value is same, 8. Next add with second value, so 8 plus 20, that is 28. Next 28 plus third value, that is 34. So you'll get 62. 62 plus 46, that is 108. 108 plus 28, 136. Next add with 14, so 136 plus 14, 150 plus 10, 160. So these are all the values of cumulative frequency. So n total is, that is summation f, 160. So in the case of continuous series, formula for Q1, that is lower quartile, is L plus N by 4 minus cumulative frequency divided by frequency into C. So now we have to find the values. So before that we have to find size of N by 4, because here we have N by 4, right? So we have to find size of N by 4. So what is N? N is 160, that is 160 divided by 4. So value is 40. So that is Q1 is size of 40th term. That we have to check in the cumulative frequency, whether we have 40 or not. See, in the cumulative frequency we don't have 40, but that 40 lies in between these two values, that is in between 28 and 62. This is Q1 class, because 40 lies in between these two values, so 62 is the Q1 class. So this corresponding F, that is 34, and the corresponding limits 20 to 30. So L is 20, and preceding value, that is 28, is the cumulative frequency value. So this is cumulative frequency of Q1. So now substitute all the values. So L is 20, F is 34, and CF is 28. So Q1 equal to L 20, N by 4, that is 160 divided by 4, minus CF. CF value is 28 divided by frequency is 34 into C. C is the class interval. Class interval here we have 10. 10 to 20, 20 to 30 till 60 to 70. So interval is 10. Now simplify this. We'll get 20 plus, and 160 divided by 4, that is 40, minus 28, so that is 12 divided by 34 into 10. So this is 20 plus, if you simplify this, 120 divided by 34. So 12 into 10, 120. If you divide this 34, you will get 3.53. So value of Q1 is 23.53. Next we have to find Q3. So formula for Q3 is L plus 3N by 4 minus CF divided by F into C. So first we have to find size of 3N by 4. So that is 3 into N is 160 divided by 4. So 3 into 160 value, that is 480 divided by 4. So the answer is 120. So 120th term. So now we have to check this 120 is in cumulative frequency or not. See here, we don't have 120, but that 120 lies in between these two values, that is 108 and 136. So the largest value is 136. This is Q3 class, and the preceding value is cumulative frequency of Q3, and this corresponding Q3 class frequency value, that is 28, and lower limit is 40. So L is 40, frequency is 28, and cumulative frequency is 108. Now substitute all the values in the formula. Q3 equal to L, that is 40, plus 3N by 4, that is 120, minus cumulative frequency is 108 divided by frequency is 28 into C is 10. So 40 plus 120 minus 108, that is 12. If you multiply with 10, that is 120 divided by 28. So 40 plus 120 divided by 28, 4.29. So the value of Q3 is 44.29. Next we have to find quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. So Q3 value is 44.29 and Q1 value is 23.53. So first find out quartile deviation. Formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. So 44.29 minus 23.53 divided by 2. So if you subtract, you will get 20.76 divided by 2. So the answer is 10.38. So this is the value of quartile deviation. Next, coefficient of quartile deviation. Formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Substitute the values. Q3 is 44.29 minus 23.53 divided by 44.29 plus 23.53. So if you subtract, you will get 20.76 divided by, if you add, 67.82. So divide these two value, you will get 0.31. So this is the coefficient of quartile deviation value. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video useful, please subscribe to my channel and click on like button. And for further notification, please press the bell icon. Thank you.